Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. It is 8 p.m. on Thursday night. This is episode 149 of Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV, and I welcome you. I am glad you are here with me. I am happy to be here. You'll see me look down because my screen is down, my camera is up. So don't think I'm ignoring you or not looking you in the eye. I'm trying. I'm doing my best, all right? So here we go. I want to, and I may back out my camera in a minute, to make this a little better. Just so you know, if you've missed any shows, we have several hundred shows over on iTunes. Okay, you can find out all that information at streetfoodvendor.tv. I'll throw that up here on the screen real quick, streetfoodvendor.tv. This is, as I said, episode 149 of Hot Dog Vendor Radio, and I'm going to answer your questions tonight, and I've got some questions already submitted. We're going to have a blast tonight. You're going to learn a lot, whether you're already vending or you're just getting started, or you're just contemplating vending. I'm going to cover a lot of different stuff tonight. I'm even going to talk about getting started with little money and how to get started in the business without even starting with hot dogs, okay? Because guess what? There's loopholes. I'm going to share those loopholes with you. So here we go. We are live, and I did not. Y'all are missing out because I used to have this cool software, and now I got a new computer and I haven't moved the software, the stuff to work with it, where I hit a button and it'd play this jingle and it'd go, you know, it'd do a rooster sound, and it was cool as heck. I don't have all that up right now, but we are going to have fun tonight. I want to tell you real quick, we've got Dice Dogs in the house, Paul Collard. I'm in the house. Martin in the house. Greg Crafton's in the house. John Fleming, Mark Payne, Tony Cook, Garrett Splain, Pat, David Ray, Paul, Warren Russell. There's Warren Russell. Lemonade Vending is in the house. Okay. And that's another one. That's another one. Okay. That will apply tonight to what we're doing. Yes, there. Martin John just asked, what about loopholes in California? There's loopholes everywhere. You'll have to find them. Okay. But I'll help you out and tell you there's some tricks to the trade, and we can get to those. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to ask that you post up your question. Heather is here tonight with me, and she's going to help me out with the questions and feed them over to me because they get mixed in amongst the comments, and then it's harder for me to find them. But feel free to comment. Feel free to do whatever on the room here in the comment section. But I will try to get everybody's questions. Hey to Alpha Dogs. Dale Porch is in the house. Max Lynn's in the house. Michael Smith is here. Owen Lewis is here. William Joseph from Boss Dogs is in the house. Martin John is in here. And I'm glad that y'all are here. I'm happy to be here. And guess what? Guess what? Unlike last Thursday, I'm sober. And so it should be a good show. It shouldn't take as long. And I shouldn't get so wordy, right? And I tend to give away the house when I'm drinking. My wife says I'm the nicest drunk she's ever seen, ever. She says I start drinking and I start giving away everything. thanks, Bubba. I'm glad you're here. Dave, the lunch pad is here. Y'all, we're going to have a great time tonight. But let me start with first by saying the vendor of the week. I need to type this in here because that'd just be the right thing to do. Let me type this in here so it's on the screen. Vendor of the week. You ready for this? It is Wobbly Wieners. I love it. Wobbly Wieners. Okay. Wobbly Wieners, congratulations to you. You can find them on Facebook. Okay. If you want to follow Wobbly Wieners, it's always good to follow these people because you pick up tips and tricks and you go, oh, that was a great idea. Did you see what the lunch pad did last week? I'm going to start doing that. And you start doing it. And nobody cares because who cares? We're all here to help each other out. If we wanted to keep it all a secret, we wouldn't even have a show, right? I've been doing a show for 8 years. And now that we have Facebook, it's even easier to do the shows. And it's easier to get to them later. But we do post up these shows, just so you know, at learnhotdogs.com every week. They go post it up there. You can subscribe. It's free. Okay. You can subscribe to the little podcast thing. It's iTunes, Spreaker, Stitcher. It's on all your favorite Podbean. It's whatever you want. Okay. So we got lots of podcasts and lots of information. Some of them will bore you to tears probably. Okay. Some of them may not relate to you. But do you want to be average or do you want to be extraordinary? I don't average. You know, I have people call me and go, Ben, what does the average vendor makes? Well, why would you even want to be average? I don't want to be an average vendor. I want to be an exceptional vendor. I want to be a Corey Lawrence vendor. I want to be a John Kavanaugh vendor. I want to be a Stacy vendor. I want to be a Leslie Hurst vendor. I want to be a Jasmine vendor. I want to be a Jason Brown vendor. I want to be a Michael Wood vendor. I want to be a Dave at the Lunch Pad vendor. I want to be exceptional. I don't want to be average. Average is easy. Everybody can attain average. That's like fall out of a window easy. We're not here for average. We're here to be better. We're here to do good and kick butt, and that's what we're here for. So we take this information. Some of it applies to us. Some of it may not. We take this information, apply what we can to us, and get better. That's how this works. Okay, so here we go. Congratulations, though, to Wobbly Wieners. That's awesome. Vendor of the Week. We randomly pick those, but thank you for being a cool vendor. Question. This comes in. Question. I hope you can help me decide on something. Well, I hope so too. I'm building a small push cart or small push food cart until I can get funds up later when I can get into hot dogs. I'm from North Carolina and my local inspector said doing funnel cakes is okay in our county. Guess what? It's okay in your whole state. To save on startup money from buying a commercial funnel cake fryer starting out, thinking of using burners on my push cart and using a steam pan to fry the funnel cakes. When I contacted WebsterOnStore.com about using a full-size steam pan, they said to use a commercial funnel cake fryer. Of course they did. People help. Please help. Can I use a full-size steam pan starting out until I can get funds to buy up? Or would you suggest using a cast iron pan to do the funnel cakes in? Thanks, Ben. Well, you're welcome. I haven't even answered you yet. You're welcome. Here's my answer. Okay. First of all, you can vend. This is a loophole. Okay. This person's question spawned what I'm going to do. At any point during this, you can type into the comments the word yes. Just type in yes. And I'm going to send you a link to a new ebook I wrote. It's free. Okay. It won't cost you a dime. If you're just getting started out, it's going to help you. If you're already started and you want maybe to add something else, but without spending a lot of money, it'll help you too. So even if you're new or you're already going, this will help you possibly. Okay. I do my best for it to help you. That's my goal, is for it to help you. Now, so you just type in yes, and you're going to get a little message with a link. Okay. Don't go there yet, though. Don't go to the link yet. Okay. Wait till the show's over, please. I like the fact that you're here. It makes me feel good. It boosts my ego. Now, let me say this. So she can vend anywhere in her state. Well, guess what? There's a little known loophole in North Carolina. In North Carolina, my neighboring state, you can vend there without a license, other than your business license, but no health department need be involved, and you can do funnel cakes. You can literally set up on the side of the road with a burner, like a turkey burner, and a cast iron skillet, and do funnel cakes with no health department approval. You can do fruit toppings and all kinds of stuff on them. 100% absolutely legal. It's a loophole. It's something they just didn't cover. And so they allow it. This person actually talked to an inspector who actually encouraged her to do it. So why not? Why not? But there's a blue million other ways too. Okay. There's lots of ways to start. And if you'll type in yes in the comments, you're going to get a message from me with a link. I'm going to send you a link. Okay. Well, I got minions behind the scenes going to send you a link. Okay. And you'll get a link. Don't panic if you don't see it immediately, but you'll get a link. And it looks like we're going to be busy with those. So either way, you're going to get a link. And I hope you enjoy it. I think you will. I think you'll love this. It will help you expand, or it will help you move at least start with little to no money. Because the subject of this tonight is I want to tell you, there's loopholes. Let me tell you how to find some loopholes. Okay. Let's say, let's just pick a random state. Let's pick Kentucky. Okay. I like picking on Kentucky. So we call up the health inspector, but I would suggest not calling the inspector in your town. I would suggest calling the state at the state level and go, hey, we're doing an article. Now, I'm telling you, this is how I would do this. Okay. I'm doing a blog article, or I'm wanting to know about vending and want to know what are there any food items that you can vend in this state without getting a health department permit? You don't have to say you're doing a blog article, but it helps. They feel less threatened for whatever reason. If you tell them you're doing it, some of them be like, what do you plan on doing? Well, what I plan on doing depends on what the heck I can do, right? Well, a lot of states have loopholes. They have like gaps they didn't fill. And most inspectors know these gaps. They know that if they roll up on Sarah over in outside of Charlotte, North Carolina, and she's got her little card table set up and she's serving funnel cakes, they can't mess with her because there is no code on it. None. You can literally, Sarah can go down. We talked about this morning. Go get her a business license for $34 and start serving funnel cakes. Well, how do you start cheaper than that? Now, let me finish answering this question real quick. She asked if she can do this in the steam table pans. Those typically, even stainless steel ones, are not cut out for high temperature, doing hot grease. I wouldn't do it. Run to the hills. Cast iron. If cast iron's too expensive, go to Big Lots, go to the dollar store, go to any thrift store, go to an antique mall. They'll have some old cast iron pans you can use. I found a square one recently, a rectangle one, thick as heck, like mammal type, you know, for doing fried taters in. Huge cast, $3. Put that on a turkey burner, and I'm just talking about a high BTU burner. Okay. Put that on that. You've now got a funnel cake operation. Does it need to have the funnel cake thing, the mixer stirred? No, you can whip it up yourself. Okay. You can take it and pour it in and do the little crazy designs, or you can buy one of them fancy squeezer things that drop it in where it looks pretty. Who gives a crap? They all taste the same, right? I will tell you to be careful working with hot grease, but you can do this. Now, what else can you do? Can you believe this? Some states allow you to do boiled peanuts. I've got a buddy that started with boiled peanuts. That's how he got started in the hot dog business. He was broke as a convict, didn't have a way to make a living, not a lick of a way to make a living. I said, he didn't even have the money for a cart. And I said, why don't you start the, I knew his state allowed the peanuts. He started the peanuts. Okay. The state has since closed that loophole. But there are other states, okay? There's other loopholes. There's other stuff. So how you find that information out is you contact them, okay? Now, to finish this question from this lady, she says that Webster Aunt Store told her to get, you know, a commercial funnel cake fryer, BS, don't do it, don't worry about it, I wouldn't mess with it, period. Wouldn't do it. Why do it if you don't need to do it? And also, if you're struggling for money in the beginning, a week from now, you can buy you a new one, okay, with your money. But why put yourself in a bind at first to have the perfect card or the perfect funnel cake maker? Who cares? Nobody cares. Don't do it. I know what it's like to go to a car lot. You start looking, you're looking at a Ford, and pretty soon you start looking at freaking Cadillacs, right? You're going, oh, well, I need the Laramie edition, you know, with the Eddie Bauer series, blah, blah, blah. I know I just mixed two different manufacturers, but either way, you get my point. You don't need it. Okay. Let the business buy the new stuff. Don't you go spend money that you may not have, or that would put you in a bind. At first, start on a slim budget. Now, I will tell you this. I've made a little e-course for you. You can type in yes right now, and it's going to send you, we're going to send you a link to it. You can download that, print it, share it with friends if you want. At the end, you will notice something. Not a big pitch, a little pitch, okay, to a course that I made that shows you all the ins and outs, like make you sick to think about the ways you can start with almost nothing. I'm talking a full-fledged course. So you can get all the information you need out of this one. But let's say you go, you know what? Ben makes a lot of sense. I'm going to do this. And you take that free course and you go, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and do this. And go ahead and get that other course and you'll see. There's states you can go right now and do the lemonades with Warren. You can do get you a squisher, get you a, and we even show you. You don't have to start with one of them pneumatic squishers. You can start with one that's handheld, you know, buy it for $35 on Amazon. But as you get busier, and that may be in your first freaking week, it was for me. I'm telling you, I filmed it. I have proof of it. Okay. I filmed it for everybody. I went down there and tried lemonade and I started with the squisher. Immediately, you'll start doing good and you'll want to switch over to a pneumatic press, a good one. And Warren makes a good one. Now, Warren doesn't pay me or anything a dime. I don't promote him because I get something back from Warren. I'm just telling you, Warren's a good guy. He's an honest guy. You can buy good equipment from him and he'll take care of you. So there. Now I need to find some questions to answer. I think I covered the basics of that. I didn't want to spend, I even wrote myself a little list so that I didn't go too long. Somebody posted last week that I went, or maybe it was this week, said I had a lot of filler in my information. It's not intentional, okay? Okay, Billy says it's working. I did get the information back from your program. Nice program you got there. Thank you, Billy. Appreciate that. I'll post that up here. Heather just sent me a question. Holy cow, she sent me a bunch of questions. Okay, you ready? I'm going to go through these questions Heather just sent me. You ready? Maxlin. No, not Maxlin. Who operates, I would like to take advantage of the Randolph Shepherd Act. Okay, we talked about this last week during my drunken episode, and I apologize that for anybody that endured that drunken episode. Okay, I answered the questions, but holy cow, I went back through it and watched that almost 2 hours of that, and it made me sick. It was embarrassing. I shouldn't have done that, and I apologize to y'all. I'm human, okay? Here we go. So, oh, wow. I love this. I love this. Okay. So I'm going to go through these questions for you. The Randolph Shepherd Act, you can Google it. Okay. It allows you to get into some national parks, state parks, and vend there where nobody else is vending. And if you have a busy state park, like, you know, on Sundays, every Sunday at 10, six of the First Baptist Church, the First Baptist, Second Baptist, Third Baptist, all the way to the Sixth Baptist Church in your county is going to be there and you can show up and make money. So look that Randolph Shepherd Act up. I have a course on it in for free for the members at Vendors United that gives you all the nitty gritty details on that. So I don't want to go too far on that because I promise them there's certain things that we keep secret, not secret like we don't want to hurt anybody. It's just, it can be abused. That this is a good, you can do your research. It's the Randolph Shepherd Act. I didn't make it up. I don't own it. You can use it. Okay. Listen to this. We have done better each time out. Because of weather, we have only been out four times, about 3 hours each. Best day so far, $160. My hubby likes to pack up and go by two. I would like to stay till six. I am hard to get going in the morning. Hubby gets me going and then I never want to leave. He tells me we're sold out. We have to go home now. Should we stay until six or not? I do not like staying till six. Okay. I didn't get into this business to work 12-hour days or 10-hour days or 7-hour days. I wanted to go out there for lunch. If you want to do an evening shift, great. The only reason I would stay from, you know, you start at 10:30, 11, and you go to 2 typically. the only reason I'd stay and go till six is if it's real freaking busy and real freaking worth it. I would not be out there, period, to just double my money. Okay. Now you might have to at first. You might feel like, oh, I got to do it. But if you don't got to do it and 160, 200 bucks a day is good, which for most people it would, do that and then find new locations, find your menu, do those things that I teach over at learnhotdogs.com first before you start working 12-hour days. Okay. You do not want to burn out. There's so much money to be made in this business without working 10-hour days or 8-hour days or even 6-hour days. You can do this with less days a week. We have vendors doing 2 days a week. We have vendors doing 1 day a week. Okay. You narrow that down to the right days, right times, right menu, right pricing. And I have all this free for you. Okay. It's free. LearnHotDogs.com. You won't have to work your butt off. You can spend your time doing things with family or doing things you enjoy, going fishing like me. I love fishing, and that's what I love to do. Now, question from Maxilyn Gwynn. This is the one I started to answer a minute ago, and then I realized I skipped one. Is it normal to pay a city a monthly fee for vendor's license, or is it a yearly fee? My town has a 500-year vendor's license, but surrounding cities, towns have 100, but some look to be monthly. I'm currently calling around to make sure what each town's regulations are. Okay, you're doing your due diligence, and you're smart, Maxilyn. You do want to call around, and you want to get the truth, but you also want to make sure that the 500-year fee is no different than Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut better be paying the same fee. McDonald's better be paying the same fee. Unless that fee is for you to operate on public property, they cannot charge you a different business license fee just because you're a different business. Okay? Let me give you an example. I own a bookstore. Not really. I'm just giving you an example. Okay. I own a bookstore and they charge me $40 a year. Bubba comes in, wants to open an adult bookstore and they tell him $7,000 a year. They just violated federal law. They cannot charge a different fee for two business entities at all. Now they can, if that $500 a year fee, which isn't that bad, it's 40 bucks a month, okay? But if they charge 500, if that is for vending on city property, public right-of-ways, city park, edge of the sidewalk stuff, they can do that because Pizza Hut ain't operating there, okay? But they can't just select a type of business and say you can't, okay? Or you can, but it's an extra fee because we don't like these kind of businesses, or we feel like we can make money off of you and we can't off Pizza Hut. No, it's an even playing field. They can't screw with that. It's the law, okay? And it's a federal law. So it doesn't matter how many city councilmen and how many times that city councilman has run and how many judges that made the rule, it's all illegal, period. It violates federal law. Hope that answers your question, Maxilyn. Question from Greg Crafton. I'm planning on selling breakfast things from my hot dog cart at a farmer's market, and the city is requiring me to get a Missouri tax ID for some reason. I doubt the farmers that they are making money have a tax ID. Isn't there a farm or a moneymaker or even a garden? Any ideas? Greg, here's the deal. Probably not. In Tennessee, farmers at a farmer's market pay no fees, no fees, other than to be there maybe through the private owner of the farmer's market. But they do not pay any extra fees to the state city government, because it encourages farmers. So the government has made rules to encourage farmers to bring their wares, okay, their cucumbers and their zucchinis and their maters to the farmer's market, and they give them a break. It's kind of like a tax break if you create a business that is around environmental friendliness, right? They'll give you a tax break. So that's basically what they're doing here. They're giving them a break. So yes, you are probably right. You will need a tax. I don't know why you'd need a Missouri tax ID unless you've never been in Missouri and that's where you're going to be operating. Then they may require it because you're not under an event organizer umbrella. So you're actually operating as a business in there, not for a special event at the farmer's market. You can talk to John Cavanaugh. He does the farm, or was doing the farmer's market before the cancer, and he was kicking butt. And he was only doing, I don't know if you followed this, Greg, back then, but John was doing thousands of dollars a weekend doing lobster rolls. He switched from hot dogs to lobster rolls and went boom at the farmer's market. John Fleming says, Ben the Street Eats Limited Company for getting in front of Home Depot website isn't working. Streets.net. Are they still in business? How do you get in front of them? Okay. Their website may be down. They are still in business. A lady called me this morning. Not a lady, a dude. A dude called me this morning. He just got his approval from them. And it's a brand new Lowe's or Home Depot that's fixing to open. And he just got his approval and he's legally going to be set up there. But you may want to try to backdoor it. You may want to try to find their phone number online. You can find it. We've posted it before on our blog and forum. Comment from Shame, received word that I would have to serve food through a window. Shane, is it still up here? No, it's not still up here. Go to learnhotdogs.com/liar. learnhotdogs.com/liar, Shane. Go there. Okay. You will find how to find out if that's true, how to deal with it if it ain't, and how to deal with it if it is. Sounds hokey. Sounds like BS. Question from Paul says, here is the question. Do you need a permit from the city if you are vending in the parking lot of a business within the city limits? Typically, yes. We talked about this last week. Okay. Not on this show, but on one of the normal Facebook lives. Let me give you an example. I'm in Sevierville, Tennessee. I have a business license. It's like $18 a year. Okay. I can go to Knoxville. Knoxville says, we don't need a business license from you. You already got one in Sevier County. We don't care if you have one here. But I go 10 minutes away to Cock County, to Newport, okay, Tennessee, and they tell me you have to have a business license here. And they can. That's legal. Okay. You're operating a business there. Now, I'm not going to an event. I'm going there to work. Okay. A regular deal. They will charge me a fee, you know, annually. It's not that much, but it's a fee. So yes, they can do that. Even though you're on private property, they can charge. It's a tax. It's a business privilege tax. They call it privilege. Okay. Of course, had there not been any businesses, there would not be any of those people, because those people are paid for because we're in business. It's kind of a, six of one, half a dozen the other kind of logic, but that's the truth of it. Martin John asks, water heater, can I tell the health department that my cart already had one when I purchased it? I have one, but it's not installed yet. Sure you can. I mean, you can tell them anything you want. Doesn't matter when it was installed. It has no bearing on anything. When you install that, it has nothing to do with nothing. Yeah. Question from Michelle. Contact some companies to get free stuff selling Pepsi products. Contact them and tell them you are using them exclusively. What can they send you so you can promote them better? I don't know if that's a question or a comment, but it is true. Some companies will give you stuff. I know Pepsi and Coke, different distributors for those companies, will give you free stuff, free banners, free hats, free shirts, if you're using them exclusively. They don't all do it, but some of the distributors will. Okay. If they know you're a regular vendor in your town and they're the distributor for your area, they're probably going to do it. You could probably call Pepsi corporate and go, hey, I'm in Podunkville, Tennessee, and I vend 6 days a week or 4 days a week in front of the Piggly Wiggly, and we only sell Pepsi products. Could we get some POP material? It's called point of purchase material. It's like signs and crap, right? Could we get some stuff we could give away, incentives? You can ask them, what does it hurt to ask? Heck, we've had vendors ask Oscar Mayer, Ballpark. We've had vendors ask Nathan's. I've got a vendor, I filmed him for y'all in Florida. He's got two carts. He's the vendor that doesn't barely making it. Been there 14 years. Now has two carts, still barely making it. Okay. Remember the poor mouthing thing? He's barely getting by with his Lexus pulling these two carts. He's hilarious. But anyway, while he's barely making it, he sells only boar's head, $7 a sandwich, and for a dog. And boar's head gave him all kinds of free stuff. Okay. Follow-up question from Maxlin. So how do you find that out? Let me go back to the question. Do you contact the county where you live, where you're going to work? Does it matter? Is it normal to pay a city monthly fee for a vendor's license, or is it a yearly fee? My town has a 500-year vendor's license, but surrounding cities have 100, but some... How do you find it out? You're doing it. You're calling them. That's how you find out. You call them and then you ask them, is that license cover me to work on city public right of way? Public right of way. That's sidewalk, city park, whatever. Okay. And they may have zones where they allow it and where they don't. But either way, if that's what the license for, great. But if that license is just because you're you, just to be in business, then all businesses have to pay the same license, period. They can't say, oh, well, he's got a pawn shop. He doesn't have to pay that. Nope. Everybody has to pay it. So if you want to look into that more, I have an article, The Liar, learnhotdogs.com/liar. That'll get you the basics, how to find out if that's even true and if they're doing it for everybody. If it's an equal opportunity, screw you over fee, or is it just a hot dog vendor screw you over fee? Okay. Dave says, what would you do when using the Vend Anywhere technique by the book and the cops and inspectors run you off? Would you ask them to give you a written citation for IJ? No. I've never heard of this. I'd love to talk to you separately, Dave, about this. Dave is referring to, I have a course called Vend Anywhere, and it will allow you to vend anywhere. It still requires permission. But permission comes like water. I mean, you can vend anywhere, pretty much anywhere. I'm serious. Federal parks, all kinds of stuff because of this neat little trick. Okay? And legally do it. But you can't just show up to the courthouse and go, well, I'm vending anywhere. No, you can't do that. You have to do, I explain it in the course, what you have to do. But here's the nice part. If you do what I say to do in the course, Dave, they're 99.99999% of the time, they won't deny you. Okay. Ford Maxlin, you told her to make sure her fee isn't different from what they're charging a Pizza Hut or set. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's the same deal. You want to ask what the fee is for, and do all businesses pay that fee? Do all businesses pay this fee, or is it just for me? Well, they may tell you that it may be an honest fee. They may go, it may be a legitimate fee. They may go, oh, well, the fee is higher than other businesses because we allow you to vend at the city park. We allow you to vend in front of the fire department, the police station, on the sidewalk, that kind of stuff. Or they may go, oh, no, we just charge vendors extra. That's where they'll be wrong. Okay. So you got to find that information out. I don't know how I got this up. I've been showing one comment this whole time, apparently. You're listening anyway to Hot Dog Vendor Radio, Street Food Vendor TV, and I'm glad you're here. My name is Ben. We've been running this show for about 8 years. Not on Facebook, though. This is episode 149 because we started renumbering them when I ran out of toes, fingers, and kids to count them on. So I don't know why we started renumbering them, but we did. At some point, we got to like 300 and something, and we said, oh, let's renumber these. And so we did. So anyway, I hope that helped. I hope that you got some value out of that. And that it gave you something. If you're just joining us, type the word yes in the comments below, get a free ebook. Okay. It's free. It won't be free forever. It's free right now. Grab it. Okay. Got another question real quick. Scott Wells, typically what kind of permits and licenses do you need to operate? This is easy. Okay. You'll always need a health department unless you're doing one of the loophole deals. Okay. Grab the free ebook. I talk about that. The loophole deal, like the lady in North Carolina doing the funnel cakes. That's a loophole one. There's people that do it with farmers market stuff, peanut stuff. Actually, corn in some states is legal without a permit. So there's things that are legal and things that aren't without a permit. There are little loopholes they haven't filled yet. Use them. Okay. The other permits or licenses you will need is a business license. You can't just go into town and go, hey, I'm a business and now I'm open. They want a business license. They want to go, okay, we're not going to call this tax. We're going to just give you a fee to be here, which is a tax. So that's it. I think that's it. I hope I answered your questions. That's pretty much the only permits or licenses you need. Your business license, your health department permit, if required, unless you're using a loophole. Okay. And depending on today, I did a show at 10 a.m. this morning here on Facebook. You can watch it. It'll be over on the blog too, learnhotdogs.com. But we did a show about Inc. LLC and sole proprietorships and talked about setting those up. You could get one of those. Probably, I mean, I'd start with, watch that video and you'll see what the deal is there. I hope that helps everybody. Hope you enjoyed this. I'm glad you joined me. I appreciate it. Look at this. I took, do I sell carts? No, Matt, we don't sell carts. We don't ship. Matt has the inside joke. I get calls daily. Do I sell carts? They literally got my number from a website that says, here's our carts. And then they ask if I sell carts. Thank y'all for joining me. I love you. I wish you the best. Keep in mind, always post your comments or questions. You can message the page and I will get to them. I may get to you privately and it may not be on the show if it's a week away from a show, or if I know I can fit it into one of my little impromptu shows I do, I'll answer it there. If you don't want me to use your name, just say, Ben, don't use my name. And I won't use your name. I'll make up a name. I'll use somebody else's name and embarrass them, because that's how I roll. I love you guys. I enjoyed it. And I'll talk to you later.